Have you ever tried cleaning your resin prints only to find that there's still some residue? Well, in today's video, we'll be addressing how to clean your 3D prints to get most out of your machine. Some of these tricks you will most likely not have heard of before. Drainage holes help reduce the amount of pressure buildup when printing a hollowed out model, but can be difficult to clean out. So long as you properly set up your prints, these can still be cleaned easily if you know a couple of tricks. In this example, I have at least two drainage holes. This means that while one hole may be releasing air or fluid, the second one will due to reverse, and this becomes more important as we begin cleaning the model. Before taking the print out of the cleaning liquid, I'll shake this around a little to dislodge some of the resin prior to draining the model. I'll orient the model so that all the fluid can drain out, but making sure to swirl the fluid around some more. I do all this while wearing protective goggles. To be sure that I've removed everything from the inside, I'll use a fine tip squeeze bottle to force liquid into the hole, allowing it to drain out of the other. When you're using a new batch of cleaning solution, you'll notice that it will eventually become clear, and this means you've removed the excess material. For really tiny prints, I use a T-steeper, which will allow you to clean these with less risk of losing the small parts. I would suggest getting one that has decently sized holes to ensure that the cleaning fluid can flow more easily within. If you made a mistake during the setup and didn't include enough drainage holes, you can add these later by using a hand drill. This will allow you to force the liquid into the area to ensure that it's completely clean before you begin the curing process. I use a small prying tool to unclog the hole, but you can easily use a toothpick as well. When uncured resin stays trapped, it can cause the model to split and crack. Therefore, it's worth investing a small amount of time in ensuring that all trapped resin is removed. I normally have a wide variety of drill bits handy since they can often be a lifesaver when working on a last minute project. This is where previewing your model will help keep these issues from arising, since it can show you where a portion of the model can fail. I highly recommend you have two cleaning containers since this can help prevent any leftover residue. One container of cleaning station can be used to remove the majority of the resin, while the secondary one will be to remove the remainder. You also find that you shouldn't need to replace the cleaning solution for the secondary material as often as a result. As I scrub the model, I often use a rag that I've salvaged from an old t-shirt and have found it to be the best in removing residual material. For tighter regions, I'll often use the tip of a silicone basting brush because it can easily scrub the tight areas without damaging the surface. Just make sure to label it so that you don't accidentally use it for anything else. While some people will use warm water to soften their models, in most cases you don't actually have to do this. Instead, simply allowing the model to soak in isopropyl alcohol for about 1 hour will often have a similar effect. Another method is to use a hairdryer to gently heat the support so they become softer as well. Another benefit of using a hairdryer is that you can quickly tell which areas still need to be cleaned by drying it off and looking for any shiny areas. Now that you have properly cleaned your prints, you're probably wondering how to actually remove the supports from your prints. Well, in this video, I'll help you do just that, so make sure to watch that one next.